Hi there, folks. It's Matt Hayson with this week's Market Wrap. And what I want to cover off this week, folks, is some of the data that's having a huge impact on the property market. Now, we're all aware of the credit crunch, but let's have a look at how that's impacted loans, starting with investor loans. They're down 28.6% year on year, or 50% from the peak. Owner-occupier loans also down 19%. And the big one here is the loan amount that people are able to borrow is down by an average of 15%. So you can see how this data is impacting the property market, particularly around the auction clearance rate, with fewer buyers moving through the market right now, and also downward pressure on prices as buyers can actually borrow less. Also, we move across into the rental market. What we're seeing is an increase in rental vacancies up to 3% right now from the norm of 2.2%. The impact of that is fairly significant. Traditionally, when we see the market deteriorate with either sale or rental, they normally act in opposite to each other. But in this change in market environment, what we're seeing is a deterioration in both the sale and rental market occurring concurrently. So what does all of this mean for consumers? Well, where is the wisest place to invest your money? 55% of Australians believe it's in bank deposits or reducing debt. Just 9% of Australians believe property is where you should be investing your money right now. That's down from 28% just 4 years ago. And also, consumer confidence right now is down 4.8% in March. That's the lowest level it's been sitting since 2017. So what's on the horizon for the property market? Well, we've got a state election on the 23rd, which probably won't have a big impact on property, but certainly the federal election will, particularly as Labor go in with a strong policy around property. Capital gains tax discounts will be reduced, i.e. it means you'll be paying more capital gains tax as you sell your investment property. And also negative gearing will be reduced for all but newly constructed property. Now, also in the last 24 hours, we've heard that the Liberals could really go in strong at increasing personal tax cuts as the price of iron ore has surged, which has really bolstered the coffers of the Australian economy. However, there's still mounting pressure on the RBA to reduce interest rates, many suggesting there could be two cuts in 2019. So is there a silver lining for the property market? Absolutely there is. We're continuing to see improvement or a better response at our auctions, with more bidders and more willingness on the part of buyers to either make a bid at auction, before auction, or in the case of private treaty. We're also seeing buyers really surge towards those blue chip areas across Sydney. Thankfully, these are the markets that we service. And also right now, we're seeing much better value, which is being widely acknowledged by the buyer pool, and they're taking advantage of this. And then finally, buyers are now aware of the lending environment, and they're being able to navigate through that in a better way and obtain their finance. So that's it for this week, folks. Thanks so much for watching. Always plenty going on in the property market, and we look forward to seeing you out and about this weekend.